Hello viewers, in this session we'll be discussing about wedge constraint problems. In that, the first example, let us see it. See, in the first example, let me consider a surface. On this surface, I'm going to place a wedge which is being moving with an acceleration of a1, making an angle of theta, and a rod is being set into contact with the wedge and it consists of an acceleration a2. It consists of an acceleration a2. Now I need to find out what is a2. What is a2? That means acceleration of the rod which is set into contact with the wedge. Is it clear? Then how to find it? See, for this type of models, the very simple technique is going to be taught to you right now. Observe it. First thing, while observing the diagram, the immediate thing which you need to get to your minds is meek artham kavalsina vishayam entante ee rendu bodies ki common tangent edi. Ee rendu bodies ki common tangent edi ante ee rendu bodies ki ee surface chudandi, ee line chudandi. This is going to act as a common tangent for both the bodies. Okay, so let me draw that common tangent which is being for the both the bodies. This is a common tangent for both the bodies. Second thing which you need to observe is, what is the point of contact? You need to identify the point of contact. Ante ee rendu bodies ki point of contact ee area ne kada. This is the point of contact. So that point of contact, represent it as a dot. A rendu bodies contact lo unnadani point of contact antamu. A point of contact identify chesi danni oka dot ga represent chestam. Ippudu a point of contact kada draw a normal line. That normal line indicates it is normal for both the bodies. It is a normal for both the bodies. That means normal line, in the sense a perpendicular line is being drawn at the point of contact of both the bodies. This is a normal line which is being drawn. After drawing it, identify the accelerations. So acceleration of the wedge is nothing but a1. Acceleration of the rod is nothing but vertically downwards, it is a2. Acceleration of the rod vertically downwards, it is a2. Now this wedge is making an angle of theta with the surface, right? So let me make an angle of theta with the surface. Since here it is theta, automatically here also it is theta. Then see, here a1 is making an angle of theta with this common tangent line, in the sense here it becomes as a1 cos theta and here it becomes as a1 sin theta. And then according to your resolution of vectors, this a1 splits into a1 cos theta and a1 sin theta. Now observe this a2 and a1. A2 and a1 are perpendicular to each other. If a2 and a1 are perpendicular to each other, here is angle theta, then here it will be the angle of 90 minus theta. Then for this dotted line and for this line, here the angle is 90 minus theta, in the sense here the angle is theta. And then ee dotted line ki line chudandi 90 degrees undali, and ikkada 90 minus theta unta, appudu ikkada entu untundi theta untundi. Ante appudu dan prakaranga a2, according to resolution of vectors, it gets splitting into a2 cos theta. It's nothing but a2 cos theta. So now if you're observing this a2 cos theta and a1 sin theta are being present on the same line, on the same normal line. So this a2 cos theta and a1 sin theta are being present on the same line, which indicates you that they both are equal to each other. Since they both are being present on the same line, kindly equalize it. If you are equalizing it, what you are happening there? a1 sin theta is equals to a2 cos theta. Since a1 sin theta is equals to a2 cos theta, see here, a1 sin theta divided by cos theta is equals to a2, which indicates a2 is equals to a1 tan theta. which indicates A2 is equals to A1 tan theta. In a very simple manner, you can get the A2 there. This is one method. The second alternate method, which you can implement here, is alternate method. Consider this as y-axis, this as your x-axis. See, this is theta and this is y and this is x. So tan theta is equals to y by x, then x is equals to, y is equals to x into tan theta. Differentiate it. See here, theta is going to be kept as constant. It is not a variable. Theta is not varying. Theta is constant, so it cannot be differentiated. So differentiate dy by t and x by t. Tan theta is kept as common, as constant. So dy by dt, in the sense velocity. Velocity on y component is equals to velocity on x component into tan theta. See, I got velocity. Vy is equals to Vx tan theta. Similarly, if I'm differentiating the velocity, with respect to time, dy by dt is equals to dvx by dt into tan theta. Then what is dy by dt? Differentiation of velocity is nothing but your acceleration. Ay is equals to ax tan theta. Here ay in the sense means a2. Ax in the sense means a1 tan theta. So a2 is equals to a1 tan theta. You can implement the vectors method, or you can implement the just geometrical conditions also. In both the cases, you are going to get the same resultant answer. Is it fine? Then second example. So in the second example, here also we are taking a surface, a wedge, making an angle of theta, moving with an acceleration a1. See, now the rod is being set into contact in this direction. Okay. Now for this, how to find out the condition? And this is having an acceleration of a2. Then how to find it? As I told you previously, the common tangent line has to be drawn there. This is a common tangent line. And the point of contact has to be identified. Identify the point of contact. This is the point of contact. At the point of contact, what is the third step? Draw the normal line, which is normal to both the bodies. So this is going to be the normal line. At the point of contact, normal line is being represented. Then represent the accelerations there. See here, your acceleration is a1, and your acceleration is being present on what? On the normal line itself. See here, your acceleration is being present on the normal line itself. For the rod, acceleration a2 is being present on the normal line itself. So since the surface is being making with an angle of theta, here is also an angle of theta. So if this a1, according to resolution of vectors, if it is making an angle of theta with this tangent, common tangent line, then this is going to be represented as your a1 sin theta, because this will be as a1 cos theta. And a2 and a1 sin theta, they both are being represented on the same normal line. That means they have to be equalized to each other. So a2 is equals to a1 sin theta is going to be your answer. A2 is equals to A1 sin theta is going to be your final resolution answer for this one. Is it clear? Third example. In this example, let us observe. I'm going to take a surface like this, and in this way, I'm going to place a wedge in this following condition. Okay, and it is making an angle of theta. This wedge is body A and this wedge is body B. It is having an acceleration of A1 and it is having an acceleration of A2. I need to find out A2. Because when the wedge A is being pushed in this manner, automatically the body B is being moving in the upper direction. When you are applying the force on the body A and when you are pushing it like this, automatically the body B is being moving in the upper direction. Body B is being moving in the upper direction by sliding with the wall. It is sliding and moving in the upper direction. Then how to find out the acceleration of this body A2, that is our body B? In the sense, I'm going to implement the same thing. If ee rendu bodies ki common tangent edi, this is the common tangent. This is the common tangent for both the bodies, right or not? Yes. So let me draw the common tangent for both the bodies. And what I told you to next second step, identify the point of contact. The same thing is a point of contact also. So I am representing a point of contact for both the bodies. Third thing, I need to draw a normal line at the point of contact. So a normal line is going to be drawn at the point of contact. A normal line is being drawn at the point of contact. Fourth thing, I need to represent the accelerations of the blocks. So according to the concept, acceleration of the block. See, this is A1. So this is A1 and this is A2 and this is A2 and here it is making an angle of theta, right? It's making an angle of theta. So this is A1, acceleration of the first block, A2, acceleration of the second block. Since it is the angle is theta here, here the angle is also theta. If here angle is being theta, then what will be this 90 minus theta? Which makes you to understand this, if this is angle theta, okay, and this becomes as 90 minus theta. Because this common tangent line and this are being normal to each other, perpendicular to each other. So now how to represent this one? See here, if this is theta, if this is 90 minus theta, according to your resolution of vectors, I can represent this one as your cos component and this one as your sine component. So on this, UA1 sine theta, you're going to get it as A1 sine theta, because here it is theta. So this is going to get it as A1 cos theta. This one is going to get it as A1 sine theta. Now A1 and A2, here it is theta in the sense, here it is 90 minus theta. If it is 90 minus theta here, for this line and for this dotted line, it is 90 degrees. So 90 minus theta and here it will become as theta. So with the normal line, the acceleration A2 is making an angle, making A2 cos theta. So with the normal line, acceleration A2 is consisting of A2 cos theta. And here it is A1 sin theta. Now A1 sin theta and A2 cos theta are being present on the same line, hence equalize both of them. So A1 sin theta is equals to A2 cos theta. So that A2 is equals to A1 sin theta by cos theta. So A2 is equals to A1 tan theta. So A2 is equals to A1 tan theta. Have you got it? The next example. Now, suppose if a surface is being present like this, and if a wedge is being present here, making an angle of theta, moving with an acceleration of A1, a rod is being present like this. Now understand, when the wedge is being moving with an acceleration A1 in this direction, this rod, which is set into contact with this wall and the wedge, right? When the wedge moves in this direction, the rod is set into contact with the wall as well as with the wedge. Ante ee wedge ittu pakka move ayye sariki ee rod kuda em avutundi, it starts to move vertically downwards. That means the acceleration of the rod is vertically downwards. ee wedge ittu move ayye sariki దాన్ని తాకుతూ రాడ్ కూడా ఏమవుతుంది కిందకు వస్తుంది అంతేనా కాబట్టి యాక్సిలేషన్ ఆఫ్ ద రాడ్ ఈస్ ఏ టు నా హౌ టు ఫైండ్ అవుట్ ఫర్ దిస్ డయాగ్రామ్ హియర్ ఆల్సో ఫైండ్ అవుట్ ది కామన్ టాంజెంట్ సో ఐఎమ్ నాట్ చేంజింగ్ ద మెథడ్ ఇట్ విల్ బి ఈజీ టు అండర్స్టాండ్ సో దిస్ కామన్ టాంజెంట్ ఫర్ బోత్ ద రాడ్ అండ్ ద బాడీ వెజ్ అండ్ ఫైండ్ ద పాయింట్ ఆఫ్ కాంటాక్ట్ సో దిస్ ఇస్ ద పాయింట్ ఆఫ్ కాంటాక్ట్ ఫర్ బోత్ ద బాడీస్ దిస్ ఇస్ పాయింట్ ఆఫ్ కాంటాక్ట్ ఫర్ బోత్ ద బాడీస్ డ్రా ఎ నార్మల్ లైన్ అట్ ది పాయింట్ ఆఫ్ కాంటాక్ట్ And next, identify the axial relations. This is A1 and rod A2. It consists of axial relation A2. And here it is an angle of theta. So here also it's an angle of theta. So what happens? A1 with this and this 90 degrees. So A1 is making an angle of theta with this common tangent line. Hence it becomes as A1 cos theta here. And here it becomes as A1 sin theta. Right? And coming to this. A2. For this dotted line and for this line, it is of 90 degrees. Since here it is theta, here it is becoming as what? 90 minus theta. So here it is theta, it becomes as 90 minus theta. If it is 90 minus theta, here it is becoming as theta. Okay, so that A2 is making an angle of theta with this normal line. That means here it is A2 cos theta. Now this A2 cos theta, A1 sin theta are being present on the same normal line. Hence they has to be equalized. Kabatti A1 sin theta is equals to A2 cos theta. So A2 is equals to A1 tan theta. Sin theta by cos theta is nothing but tan theta. So A2 is equals to A1 tan theta. Have you got it? And the next example. Observe. Here is a wedge. And one more wedge is being set into contact with this. And if this is sliding onto the surface, and there is one more surface making an angle of alpha, and here it is sliding here, here it is an angle of beta. Okay, so now this is been moving with an acceleration of A1. And this has been moving with an acceleration of A2. Have you understood it? So a wedge is being moving in this direction. This is wedge A and this is wedge B. Wedge A has been moving in this direction. Wedge B has been moving in the upward direction. As wedge A is having the acceleration in downward direction, and wedge B is being pushed in the upward direction. Then how to find out? See here, this is a common tangent. So this is a common tangent I'm going to identify. The point of contact is also present here itself. So this is a point of contact. For this point of contact, what should I do there? I should draw the normal line. So at point of contact, normal line is being present there. How is the acceleration? The acceleration of body A is in this direction with an angle of alpha. So acceleration A1 with an angle of alpha, right? And how is this acceleration of body B? It is moving in the upper direction with an angle of beta. It is moving in the upper direction with an angle of beta. Observe. It has to, when it is sliding down, this body has to slide in the upper direction, right? So it is making an angle of beta. So this is nothing but A2. So now what happens? It's making angle theta with the normal line. This also is making angle of alpha with the normal line. So this becomes A2 cos beta and A1 cos alpha. So A1 cos alpha, and this becomes as A2 cos beta. So since they both are present on the same line, equalize both of them.
So A1 cos alpha is equals to A2 cos beta. So A1 by A2 is equals to cos beta divided by cos alpha, or else A2 by A1 is equals to cos alpha, A2 by A1 is equals to cos alpha by cos beta. Cos alpha by cos beta. Is this clear? The last example.
Suppose if a wedge is being present here, making an angle of theta, and one more wedge is been set into contact. And is being present like this, and this is wedge A and this is wedge B, and it is being present on the surface. Wedge A is having the acceleration in this direction, so automatically wedge B will be sliding down. That means wedge B acceleration is in this direction. Okay, so then the common tangent line, point of contact, normal line for both the bodies, acceleration identification, A1 is the acceleration at point of contact, A2, so this is A2. What is happening there? Since it is making an angle of theta here, here also it makes an angle of theta. That means this is A1 making an angle of theta at the common tangent line. So this becomes as A1 sin theta as per your resolution of vectors. This is because A1 cos theta, A1 sin theta. And now this angle becomes as 90 minus theta. Then this becomes as theta. So A2 with this normal line, this becomes as A2 cos theta. A2 cos theta, A1 sin theta on the same line, hence equalize both of them. A1 sin theta is equals to A2 cos theta. So A1 tan theta is equals to A2. That's it. So these are the sum of the models based on your wedge based conditions. Is it clear? So I kindly request you to refer to our previous videos done on your pulley block systems. How to find out the tension present in the string, acceleration, velocities when the body is being sliding. Everything is being clearly explained in our videos with the help of a shortcut tricks itself. So I kindly request you to refer to the playlist so that you can understand more and more regarding these concepts. Thank you.